started surfing almost immediately after we moved here, so a little over 40 years. We started going to the beach with the kids.
With him, it's an obsession, the surfing. It's just kind of what we grew up with.
It's like a whole encompassing lifestyle for him, and he just loves it.
My name is Bob Kiefer, 75 years old. My wife Nancy and I have 3 adult children and 6 grandchildren.
I found out from a friend of his who called me from the beach and said, Bob just went in an ambulance. He was talking to us at the beach, but he's having a heart attack.
I do know that I had been surfing for a while that morning, came in. I was apparently in the process of taking my wetsuit off, and I told them to take me to Mission Hospital.
When the emergency room brought him in, I think Bob was still in his wetsuit. They had actually had his heart stop several times along the way and actually had to defibrillate him.
They came in and said, we need to go in right away, get his heart going and get him breathing and try to get him stabilized. So we knew it was gonna be tough.
He came in what we call cardiogenic shock, where the heart is unable to pump enough blood out to the rest of the body. So to really kind of get him to the quickest therapy possible, the first thing we did was put the Impella device in, which, as you know, is a pump that takes over the function of the heart. So it allows the heart muscle to rest as we are reestablishing blood flow. So this is where you came in. That was the screen where we had you and had your pictures up, and the Impella came in right around this side, and there's the defibrillator that probably shocked you a couple of times. With the Impella, allowed his heart that time to recover, such that by hospital day 4 or 5, we got his heart function up into the low 40s. And then with the other medications and things that we use now, his heart function is about 55 to 60%, which is right in the middle of the normal range. The team is on point, and the getting the devices in and everything just happened so quickly. You know, that's how we're able to get around to getting the device in, unloading your heart, and really kind of letting it rest to heal up after the event like you had it.
I feel fantastic.
I'll give you another hug.
Okay.
We started on follow-up appointments, and Dr. Bojraj mentioned to me that he had thought about surfing, but he was afraid of sharks. And I said, well, really not much chance that you're gonna get attacked by a shark. So I convinced him to try it a couple of times, and from the first day that he did it, I could tell he was in another zone. He was just enjoying himself so much.
One of the things that I really enjoy about being out there in the water is kind of the calm that it brings over you.
It's so gratifying. I might choke up. I owe him so much. It's probably the only way I could repay him, and it's a fraction of what I owe him.
Just to see him hop on those waves is just, it's an amazing feeling to know that I contributed to Bob and to be able to allow him to continue to catch wave after wave after wave.
This goes way beyond a doctor-patient relationship. It's a real bond.
He's really lucky.
You know, I wait for him to come back late morning so he can tell me about how his waves were, and it's just a joy to have him back doing what he loves.
With every kind of experience like this, you appreciate every minute that you have afterwards. And so when I have days like this that are perfect, it's euphoric. It just goes from one euphoric moment to another.